What is up, you guys? Welcome to the video. So obviously, based on the title, today we are going to be talking about how to create calorie deficit. I'm also going to briefly explain, you know, what even is it, but mainly how do you create your calorie deficit that's going to work for you. So if you're new here, my name is Sydney. My channel just has lots of stuff on fitness, nutrition, all of that fun stuff. So if you enjoy those kinds of topics, be sure to subscribe so that you don't miss any videos. But let's just go ahead and jump into this video. So when it comes to being in a calorie deficit, this is a question that I get asked a lot about, and it's actually a video that I did a while back that has done really well because I think that this is just a really hot topic. So I did want to make an updated video just to kind of get it in a more condensed and simpler manner. That video did do really well, but just wanted to kind of do an updated one. So with that being said, what is a calorie deficit? So basically, when we look at calories in versus calories out, all that a calorie deficit means is that we are taking in less energy than we are expending. So if you are burning, let's say, 2200 calories a day, but you're eating 1700 calories a day, you're going to be in a calorie deficit. But our metabolisms are very adaptive, so that's where the confusion kind of comes in. And just, you know, the fitness trackers and what the machine says and all of this stuff is kind of the things that I hear that people get the most confused about. So we're going to do a little overview. So the first thing I wanted to note was, you know, a lot of people will go to an online calculator to determine their calorie deficit. So the thing with online calculators and why I don't suggest you using this is because, number one, they are just simply based on an equation. So they're going to use things like your height, your age, your gender, whatever else that you put in there. And that's how they're going to determine that, which, I mean, that's the best that a calculator can do. So it's not bad by the calculators. It's just not going to be the most accurate way. And they usually are going to end up overestimating what you're burning in a day and what your calorie deficit needs to be for the most part. So I would honestly avoid using online calculators. If you do, I would say use a couple of different ones and get an average of those and go with that. But we're going to get into what I would recommend. But if you want to do that, that's what I would do. So when it comes to our metabolism, because when we're trying to create a calorie deficit, we have to know how many calories am I burning on average in a day. That's the very first step that we need to know. And what makes up how many calories we're burning in a day is our metabolism, just like how fast we're going through fuel, burning that energy. So that's what even makes up how many calories we burn in a day. And there's four components to our metabolism. I'm going to cover these very briefly. First one is going to be BMR. So that's just like your basal metabolic rate, what you need to just like be. And this is going to be determined a lot by body composition. Also though, gender, height. But like the more muscle that you have, the more calories that you're going to burn just to live. So this is highly impacted by body composition. Second one is going to be physical activity. So obviously that's any calories that you're burning when you are doing physical activity, such as a class, a workout, whatever that may be. And then the next one is going to be our non-exercise activity thermogenesis. So that's going to be the calories that we burn from tasks outside of just like our intended workouts. So that could be walking your dog. That could be going to get your mail. That could be me fidgeting, walking into the grocery store, all those little daily tasks. If you tap your foot when you work, little things like that all will add up. And then you also do have to remember though, like for some people, a walk might actually be physical activity, kind of depending on the person's fitness level and how, you know, in shape that they are. But both of them are going to contribute to your total calorie burn for the day. The fourth part of our metabolism is going to be the thermic effect of food. So that is the calories that our body burns to digest, utilize, absorb the foods that we eat. So these four things really make up what we burn in a day. You know, our body has to burn calories to keep us alive. The more muscle we have, the more calories we're going to burn that way. we burn calories, obviously, through little movements throughout the day, through our physical activity, and then through actually digesting our foods. So to be in a calorie deficit, let's say that for all of these processes here, we burn 2,000 calories, just for ease of numbers, then to be in that deficit, we need to be eating less than 2,000 calories. The thing, though, to remember is that our metabolisms are very adaptive, and that is one reason why online calculators is not something that I would recommend. So if you have been, let's say, reverse dieting, you can increase your metabolism through eating more food in that way. So your metabolism may be in a higher place than, say, somebody who has chronically dieted for a long time, or even if not chronically, just dieted. Your metabolism is going to down-regulate as you diet. So like if you were in a diet, or you had, let's say that you've kind of been doing low calorie diets for your whole life and you kind of go on these like restrict then overeat cycles, your metabolism is likely very down regulated with all of these reasons, because our metabolisms are adaptive. So whatever we do, they adapt to it. So we can't, if you're somebody who has been under eating, whether it be intentional or unintentional, for a long time, and let's say your metabolism has adapted down and your maintenance now is like 1300 calories. Well, if you use an online calculator, it might tell you that your deficit needs to be at 1700, but for you, that is going to be a surplus because your metabolism has adapted. So before I get into how I would determine your calorie deficit, I want to reference you guys to a video that I did on, are you ready to go into a fat loss phase? Because if you're one of those people whose metabolisms are downregulated, you will need to spend some time reverse dieting and getting your food up so that you can actually create a deficit from a healthy place. So I will link that video below. It's called, are you ready for a fat loss phase? I think that's what it's called, but I will link that below. I also have a video on setting protein and calories for fat loss once you are ready for a fat loss phase. So I will link both of those below. But getting into how are we gonna figure out our deficit if we're in a good place to go into one. So the first thing that we're gonna do is track our food for a week. And this is what I use with clients as well. So we're gonna track our food for 1 week and we're not gonna change anything. So if you normally have a whole bag of chips at night, keep eating a whole bag of chips at night, or at least track that. Don't change anything if you have, and this is food and drinks too. So I know it can be hard to not change anything because you're like, but I'm trying to make a change in my life. Like I wanna, like, and when you're thinking about tracking, like you wanna start changing things, but you need to get an actual assessment of where you are. So I would recommend MyFitnessPal, super easy app to use. There's also other ones like MyMacros+, whatever you wanna use, but I recommend MyFitnessPal. So you're gonna track for 1 week and then you're going to get an average of all of those days. So track for a week, add up the calories from every single day, divide it by 7, that's gonna get you an average for your week. So from there, you need to know what has your weight been doing. So if this is the average amount that you're eating and your weight has just been staying relatively the same for a while, fluctuating between like 1 to 3 pounds or maybe a little bit more, then you're probably, that's probably your maintenance calories. Now, if you've been gaining weight at this intake that you've been consuming regularly, then you've probably been eating in a slight surplus, maybe a big surplus, depending on how much weight that you've been gaining. If you have been losing recently, then you've probably been in a deficit. And if you're watching this video, that's probably not what's happening. So with that, we're going to get where we are, and that's where we're gonna start. So again here, if you realize, oh, I've been eating, especially if you're like a female, let's say you've been eating like 1400 calories or so, and you have been maintaining or even slowly gaining weight, then I would not go into a deficit yet. I would go watch that other video, spend some time getting your food up so that you can actually see success in your fat loss. But for the next thing, so, and this is, I guess, what I just said. So our calories are already low and you're not losing weight. Again, go watch that video, because if you try to create a deficit from a maintenance of 1400 calories, you are going to get into some not very good things and you're really not going to be able to progress for very long, and it's not going to be a very healthy way or sustainable way to go about it. So let's say though your calories are in a fine place, and again, go watch that video to know if they are, but if they are in an okay place, then what we're gonna do, so let's say that you figured out that you were eating about, this is just for ease of numbers, 2,000 calories a day, and you've been maintaining your weight. Okay, so cool, we know that your maintenance is 2,000 now. If you had been eating 2,600 calories and slowly gaining weight, we know, okay, well, we were probably in a slight surplus there. So what we're gonna do to create our calorie deficit, there's really two ways that we can do this. The first one is gonna be decreasing our food intake. And the second way is going to be increasing our energy expenditure from our activity, whether that be our meat or our physical activity. So those are the two ways. So again, with a calorie deficit, it's about eating less than we are burning throughout the day so that we can create that gap to be in that energy deficit. So it's not all about cardio. We can use cardio, but we also have to be sure that, you know, we're focusing on our nutrition too. So the first way is going to be from decreasing food intake. So decreasing overall calorie intake. If you want to know how much protein you should be eating, that video will be linked below too in the calories and protein for fat loss. So that's the first way that we can create our deficit is through our food intake. So what I would recommend is decreasing by a couple hundred calories, about like 15 to 20%. So if you were at that 2,000 calories, take 15% of 2,000, which I don't have a calculator with me right now, but I can put that up on the screen. And you're gonna take, like, let's say 15% of 2,000, you're gonna subtract that number from 2,000, and that can be a good starting place for your calorie deficit. And that's gonna be the first way. The other way is gonna be through increasing activity. So this could be through going on, you know, more outdoor walks. This could be, okay, let's start with 4 20-minute incline walk sessions on the treadmill, whatever. What we don't want to do is slash calories super low and add a ton of cardio at once, because like I said, our metabolisms are adaptive. So if you do that, you may make progress for a little bit, but then you don't really have much room to work. So what I would recommend is start moderate, make that small drop, and just add a little bit of cardio at first. And then, like I said here, we don't want to drop too low, because what can happen when you drop your calories too low too fast is you can lose that muscle mass. And like I said, muscle is going to increase our BMR, how many calories we just burn at rest. So we don't want to be losing any of that. And if you're going for like a toned, defined look, you want to be able to maintain your muscle mass. So we don't want to drop too low too fast. So I would recommend figure out your maintenance by tracking for the week. And then you want to make that slight decrease in calories, about 15 to 20%. And then you want to start with just a little bit of activity. And then what you'll notice is you'll make progress for a little bit, and eventually you will stall because our metabolisms are adaptive. So then what you can do once you stall is you can pull out, you know, a couple hundred calories. You won't want to continue to do like a 15 to 20% drop every single time. That's more for the initial one. And then you'll want to make them a little bit smaller for your drops. So you'll want to, whenever you do stall, you can pull out some food, or you could add 10 minutes onto each cardio session, or you could add two more cardio sessions, whatever that looks like for you. Or you could do a mix of both. Maybe you drop by 100 calories, and instead of 4 times 20 minutes, you do 5 20-minute sessions. And then, you know, there's also always the option to add in eventually if you want to add in like some HIIT intervals. Not overdoing it though, maybe like 5 intervals a week, something like that. But the thing to remember here is there's no need to just add just to add. We really want to be sure that we are being smart about this, and basically wanting to get results on the highest amount of food, lowest amount of cardio possible. But each time that we stall, we do have to kind of create that deficit again, because since we adapt, our body creates this new maintenance, and we have to reinitiate that deficit, whether it be through decreasing food a little bit more, adding a little bit more cardio, or a mix of both. So that's really it, you guys. It's really, really simple. You just need to figure out your maintenance, and then from there, you create that deficit through either dropping your food a little bit, adding cardio, a mix of both. Because again, all that we're trying to do is, if we're burning 2,000 calories a day, and we create that deficit, then we have that gap where we can progress. One thing that I did want to note though is that you don't want to add back your workouts. So like in apps like MyFitnessPal, there's an option to track your workouts in there, and you don't want to do that. Because let's say that we're creating our deficit and then you add in a workout that's burned 300 calories, which isn't going to be that accurate anyways, by the way. So I wouldn't even count on those. But let's say that you added back in that 300 calories and then you like ate that back. Well, then you're kind of closing that gap on your deficit. So we don't want to do that. We're just going to keep workouts as a baseline. You know, you don't need to get super caught up in how many calories you burn in each one and try to adjust your intake on that. Just kind of let that be and let that be a baseline, and then adjust your food and your cardio based on how your body's responding, and let that physical activity just be like a constant. But we don't need to add it back. We don't need to eat it back, anything like that. So that's going to be the calorie deficit video. I hope that this was helpful for you guys. If you have any questions, drop them below. If they are super specific to like you, I do offer one-on-one coaching if that is something that you're interested in. My spots are currently full, but they will be open at some point. So, you know, keep checking back if that's something that you're interested in. But if you just have like general questions, drop them below. It's just really hard for me to answer super, super detailed specific scenarios because everybody's gonna be so different, and like I would have to know a lot more about you. But general questions, feel free to drop them in. Again though, if you are in a place where you're already eating low calories and you're not seeing progress, you need to spend some time reverse dieting. Again, check out those videos below. But for anybody else, this can be super helpful. And once you do reverse diet, this could be super helpful after that. So hopefully this is helpful. Give us a thumbs up, share it with somebody, and comment below if you enjoyed it. I try to make it like as concise as possible, even though I kind of always ramble in my videos. But that's gonna be it for me. So again, I hope that you enjoyed it, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.